Hi, good evening everyone. Thanks so much for being here. I'm Sumaira Abdi. I'm with CNBC TV 18. This is our new initiative. It's called the Investing Edge. So once again, thanks very much for being here. I have Feroze Azeez, who's the Deputy CEO. He is one of the youngest wealth managers in the country. And before we get started, I'm going to invite Feroze on stage to share with you some of the nuggets that he's actually picked up over his own journey of wealth management, and what are some of the tips that he'd want to share with you?
Objective 1A is to beat inflation. Mehengai ko mat dena. Government assumes half your money is going to be spent in a kirana store. Is that how you spend your money? Most HNIs don't even spend 1-2% buying dal and chawal. Poor man or poor lady unfortunately spends 17-18% on transport. HNI spend not more than 0.5% on petrol and diesel bills. So what do they spend on? If we calculated the inflation for this group, it came out to 12%. Why? Because HNIs are consuming something very different than the rest of the group. What are they consuming? They're consuming sophisticated medical care, banquets for their children's marriage, education abroad, brands, club memberships. All this, unfortunately, is inflating at a higher rate because it is always in short supply. Objective 1B, a very important but simple looking objective, keep a target. In wealth management, most individuals I have met, HNIs, sophisticated ones, don't have a target and an actual. Most often than not, you get a report saying I'm at 5 crores, 7 crores, whatever that number is. There is no target and an actual. In small things in life, we have targets and actual. What a vazan ghatana hai, 10 kg vazan ghatana hai, 7 ghat chuka hai, 3 aur ghatana hai. Similarly, should your balance sheet have a target is a question we have to ask. If you already have a target, great. As soon as you have a target and an actual, you will course correct far sooner. So what is a good target to have in India? It is to quadruple your wealth in a decade. If you can quadruple your wealth in a decade, then it's a good target, which is nothing but 15% compounded. Agar aap apne paise ko 15% se izafa kar paaye, to 10 saalon mein 4 guna ho jata hai. And once you know a 10-year target, a simple Excel sheet will tell you everyday target. Then whenever you meet your advisor, you have to check, what was my target today, what's my actual? That's a good management information support system. Objective 1C is to make sure that the pre-tax and post-tax difference is as little as possible. See, if let's assume two people have earned you 15%, both optically look identical. One guy earned you 20, paid 5% tax, brought you to 15. The other guy earned 16, paid 1% tax, brought you to 15. Both of them are 15. Whom should I choose? I should choose this guy because this guy took the risk of 16, gave you 15 in your pocket. This guy took the risk of 20, gave 15 in the pocket. If you don't measure this, both are equal. You will be indifferent between them. Ideally, treasury mein isko double bonus milega isse. Iska toh naukri jane ke khatra hai. Taxation is the only free lunch you have. Everywhere else, if I earned you a rupee, you are taking some risk which didn't fructify maybe. Tax is the only free lunch, so you will have to be on the driver's seat with some element of taxation. That's an advisor's job. Objective 2 is to make sure when there is a rainy day, if God forbid, when I turn to my best friend, which is money, it is available for me. If it is not available for me, you were living in an illusion that when I need the money, it will be there. Now, when we see these 5,000 families, 4,500 families, which we manage, at a point in time, we see several people, 30, 40, 1% of the people going through the situation where they have a liability. They assumed that their money will come to their rescue, but the money, the liability has spilled over to the money and the money is attached. Could be various reasons. If I illustrate all the reasons which we have seen in this journey, you will be surprised of where all liability can come from. You're a director in a company, you can have a liability. You're a chairman in a housing society, you can have a liability. I personally think every HNI should have a vehicle where he can put some money and take care of its dependents. I grow my money, hopefully. I protect my money from any encumbrances. The third 100% probability event is that we have something in common, between everybody in the room that we all have a finite life. We all have the same finite life. We will someday be no more. Not planning for this transition of money from one karta or the one custodian to the next custodian is not a good thing to do because it's a 100% probability event. It's not good management to leave any loose ends untied. There are five big reasons why we have seen HNIs lose money when they transmit it. One reason could be family dispute. Okay, India has this problem, but globally, making a will and making it transparent is mandatory in a few countries, where you have to write to each constituent of your will saying that, bhai sahab, aapke haq mein itne paise hain, inke haq mein itne paise hain, sabke constituents ke share aapko batane padenge jite ji. Otherwise, your will is null and void. Hamare desh mein wo suspense item hai. The second reason is we have bought products from 10 different people across 30 years. Definitely, koi na koi product aapki nazaron se chhooti jayega. 30,000 crores of unclaimed money lies with the mutual fund and the insurance industry. So point is, unclaimed deposits is one big reason. Third is inheritance tax. Okay, we've been saying this for the last 5 years and I've had large debates in gatherings like this. Inheritance tax aa hi nahi sakta India mein. So if you look at the 10th July 2010 budget, 2014 budget, Arun Jaitley said that I'm going to give you a gift. 1% wealth tax is abolished. And he also said, this is a precursor to bring back inheritance tax. We are all enjoying that 1% wealth tax, which is being abolished. It is so logical for the government to not come and collect 1% from Feroze every year when it's certain that he's going to die. At that point in time, I'll take 30. So inheritance tax aayega, to aaj ka jo zero hai, kya wo shunya, aap lock kar sakte hain? Maine apne aadhe paise ke liye shunya lock kar rakha hai. Aapko karna hai, nahi karna hai, uski deliberation ho. It should be a matter of choice, not a matter of ignorance that I could have done it. Fourth reason, people give assets which the other person doesn't even know to manage. See, my kitab has some derivative. If I gave this to my wife after my life and she doesn't know what is derivative, then how did I give her an asset? I've given her a liability. So the point I'm trying to make is you have to also inculcate the capability to drive the car you're giving, right? Or give the car which the other person knows to drive.
Feroze, I'm sure you spoke about this 15% a lot. So that would have some resonance with a lot of people. For an average 15%, something would give 20, something would give 8, something would give 12, and so on and so forth, right? How do you get to this mix?
When you create a portfolio as an advisor, you have to solve for return, 15, risk 8, and something called skew, which means aadha samay mujhe 15 se zyada mile, aadha samay 15 se kam mile. That is acceptable. Okay, Alex? That is called 50-50. See, if I told you 15, now just visualize. I told you 15, tomorrow you become my client. For three consecutive years, if I kept showing you 4%, 5%, 2%, will you be patient till the fourth year? Very unlikely. Okay, if I look at HNI behavior, anybody's behavior as a human being, if I say 15, but all the 3 years, first 3 years, you got 3, 4, 5. Aapka wo 15 se vishwasi chala jayega. Fourth year might be 35, but you will pull the plug before the fourth year. Correct? So most of the time, if you have to stay the course, I have to give you sometime 17, sometime 13. Otherwise, what will happen? You will never stay the course. The problem with equity markets, which people put their money in equity, but they don't realize this problem of equity. Equity follows a very bad habit. That habit statistically has a name. It follows a bad habit which says every year it will give you less than average. Hamesha less than average dega. Phir ek bumper saal dega, wo pure kharab saalon ki makeup kar dega. This is the problem, which is what the advisor needs to solve. So what am I trying to say? If there is a variable which gives you most often than not less than 15, it's not a good idea. So advisor needs to solve for the third thing, which is called skew. Aadha samay zyada dunga, aadha samay kam dunga, to client ka vishwas bana rahega, varna wo apne paise pehle nikal lenge. Aur unka hi nuksan hoga, mere se zyada. So that is called skew. If you look at the last 30 years of Nifty, 30 saalon mein, अगर 30 सालों की एवरेज कितनी है, 15% की रिटर्न की एवरेज है, 15% इज ग्रेट, राइट? तीन साल, इफ यू रिमूव 3 years आउट ऑफ द 30 years, द रिटर्न ड्रॉप्स टू 6%. व्हाट डज इट मीन? इट मीन्स दैट द नेक्स्ट 9 years इट केप्ट ट्रबलिंग यू. 1 year इट मेड अप फॉर ऑल ऑफ दैट. सो द पोर्टफोलियो हैज टू बी डिजाइंड टू सॉल्व फॉर दिस प्रॉब्लम, which is what is the habit of this animal called equity, which in technical terms is called chi-square, C-H-I-square, chi-square. You should Google this. If you have 1 rupee in equity, you are duty bound to know what is the distribution of that equity. So what does that mean? It means that if 15 milega, but saal dar saal 15 nahi milega. Aap dekh lijiye na, Modi ji last time aaye the, pehle saal 2% ki return, dusre saal 3% ki return, teesre saal -1% ki return. चौथे साल 28% की रिटर्न. व्हाट डिड इट डू? एवरेज आ गया 9, बट तीन साल क्या हुआ? कुछ नहीं हुआ. अगर किसी ने मेरी बात सुनकर 15 का उम्मीद पे लगा दिया होता और मैंने पोर्टफोलियो में उसकी करेक्शन ना की होती तो चौथे साल तक वेट ही नहीं करते, राइट? तो 28 का जो मजा लेना था, जिसके लिए आपने 3 साल सफर किया था, उसके पहले वो निकल गए. सो एडवाइजर्स हैव टू सॉल्व फॉर दिस काई स्क्वायर प्रॉब्लम. That's what.
Okay, so basically, what you're saying is that there are products which will counter the downturn in an equity market, right? So yes. There are lots of products, and I'm sure between the 300-400 people who are sitting here, they pretty much have delved with some of them. But Feroze, over the years, I've only heard you talk about what 3 products that you like, yeah. Right? So one, of course, is equity, and we'll get to that. But what's this animal called structured products, and why don't we hear much more about it?
Yeah. So first is, there are 21 types of distinctly different products I can give you as a wealth manager. Over the last few years, if we have realized that what not to be done is as critical as to decide what's to be done. For the last 7 years, we have banned 17 of them. 17, 18 of them are banned in Anand Rathi system. Why? Because data clearly shows they are innovative not for the reason that they will create value. They are innovative for the reason that they will create commission, and the existence of wealth manager would be substantiated. So it's very important to find out why would you ban them. Now all of us will have some ULIPs. If we deal with banks, we are sure to have been pushed a ULIP. We analyzed 2,000 ULIPs owned by different people. 2,000 ULIPs owned by different people held for 10 years. Average return 4.62%. Would I not ban this for my dad? Would I not ban this for my portfolio? Self-made money? I would. But will I ban it for the client? May not be, because it gives 50% commission. So every time I interview a person, the first question I ask him, because as a private banker, I have interviewed about 300-400 in the last 3 years. I have hired 100. Aap apne papa ke liye kya kharidte hain? Aapke chacha ke liye kya kharidte hain? Kitna intersection hai client ke aur aapke portfolio mein? Negligible nikalta hai. So, AIF, right? Alternate investment funds has 3 different categories, 1, 2, and 3. Third one, I'll leave it aside. Category 2, which deals with private equity and real estate funds. Private equity and real estate. Real estate is an asset class where you should never put structured money. Okay, I learned this from a mistake which I did for my client. I put 3 crore rupees in one fund. I can't name it, of course. Because it's a televised event. 3 crore rupiah maine dalwaya client ka 2006 mein. 2016 mein ye pata laga ki client product ne 3% ki return banayi. 2006 was the boon period of real estate. 3% ki return banayi. Then I was very, very curious. Maine mein jigyasa jagi ki I want to figure out why 3%. Yaar, it takes an artist to make 3% in a market. If I bought an apartment in Mira Road, I would have quadrupled my money. Right, which didn't require any science or any construction capability, nor the intellect of real estate. That's because I felt very stupid to think that how did I, such an obvious thing, that 1,000 crore rupees unko unhone collect kiye in a market where they promised to buy land, construct on it, and zero cash is given. All pan paid money is given. In an unstructured market, can you have such structured money? You want somebody else to manage your money. Make sure that the price of that asset is available in public domain. If 2 people are discussing the prices in a closed room, you are invoking the strongest emotion called greed.
now the good news is that my questions are over. So you can ask questions. Is there anybody who would like to go first? Yes, we have a gentleman at the back. Yes, sir, please, could you stand?
Suppose you have got X number of fund selection. What would you advise to a common man which he can manage so that the swing remains with this few funds in plus or minus one sigma?
You can never influence sigma. The swing will be wherever it has to be. You can only influence the extent of swing. If 8 is not good, then you have to redesign your portfolio to make it 4. Now, for example, there's some treasury which I manage, which has given a mandate, which says 12 should be my return. My standard deviation should be between 3 and 4. You should never give an advisor a mandate only with return. You have to give it, it's an incomplete sentence. So you can only influence the standard deviation. The two swing will mean automatically the second swing will become narrower. You can use something called a model which won Nobel Prize, Markowitz. Hamare business mein, portfolio management mein, ek hi aadmi ne Nobel Prize jeeta hai, wo Markowitz saab hai. Unki theory ke hisab se, he does what? So I use Markowitz to come to 8 funds. What it does is, let's assume there are 10 instruments which have 13 ka risk, puron ka, hypothetically. You can combine them in certain proportions. All of them are 13, but the combination will have 11. Because both can go in opposite directions. So Markowitz assumes and takes 10,000 portfolios and tells you which is the most efficient portfolio for a given level of risk taken. So if you did this, then you get 8 funds. Like for example, then my aspiration, I call that the Anand Rathi model portfolio. And I follow the model portfolio personally. So in the evening when I open the portfolio, I should be able to see 4,000 other portfolios. So we are urging, unfortunately, we realize this late in time, saying that why should there be a difference between my portfolio and the client's portfolio at a mutual fund level? So that is called the model portfolio, and we're implementing it with each client and telling them humbly, saying that converge it to our portfolio. If your risk is low, put smaller amount of money. If my risk is high, I'll put more amount of money.
I have a problem. See, in case of mutual fund, as an investor, individual investor, I have some control. I can monitor, not control, I can monitor. Looking at money control and, you know, and the bullish spread and bearish spread, I can take a decision. In case of PMS, I have no control. What is the level of monitoring for a passive investor? I'm not saying control, monitoring.
SEBI said that all PMSs have to be in your own DMAT account, so everybody's return is different. Unlike in mutual fund, all people who entered on the same day, exited on the same day will have same return. And PMSs also don't provide audit reports of their overall. They take their best portfolio sometimes and report and all that. So I don't do PMSs at all for the last 7 years. PMS as an industry went through a huge paradigm shift in the assets it had. Okay, and I see no logical reason for it to be that way. PMS was a 15,000 crore industry from 15 years. 1999 mein ICICI ne pehla PMS launch kiya tha. So udhar se 15 saal tak 15-20,000 crore ki assets thi. 2015 April mein kuch aisa hua ki sabko ye durdrishti aa gayi, ye bahut acha hai product. Aaj uske lakh, 2 lakh, 3 lakh crore tak pahunch gayi. Aisa kya hua tha April 2015 mein? Hand on heart, mutual fund commissions on 1st April 2015 were capped to 1% upfront. PMSs can pay me, if I tie up with the PMS, I can get upfront 55%, 4%. People have come and offered me 7%. So upfront commissions is the largest reason why PMSs are being sold. Now, of course, people have this benefit of a concentrated portfolio. So advisors say commission is not the reason, sir. Concentrated portfolio. If somebody makes this statement, he should also know which is the most concentrated mutual fund portfolio. Actually, SEBI carved out a competition for PMS on April 1st, 2018 called focused equity. There is a separate category of mutual funds which are now concentrated. So the most concentrated mutual fund portfolio is a 13 stock portfolio managed by Mrinal Singh ICICI Focused Equity Fund. Agar mutual fund mein 13 stock ka portfolio hai, to usko pata hona chahiye ki bhai ye acha nahi hai, ye khareedna chahiye. So PMS has a concentration story. On April 1st, 2018, PMS's existence is even more a question mark because mutual fund has a concentrated bet possible. It has a tax efficiency because it does not have it happen on your kitab. So what should you do? What kind of monitoring does a passive investor need? You should give 1 hour a month. That is the frequency at which we recommend the client should meet for a simple review, where the spouse is there or whosoever money is there or the child. So that you give them an update of how the month has gone. And you do a monthly review, very small review, but a full-fledged annual review to revisit the strategy.
I want to understand more on LEAPS. Like, you mentioned that this contract is for 3 years. So if something happens to the market in 1 year time, will I be able to encash that?
You'll be able to encash it, but not to the extent of the full fall. So firstly, what can LEAP do? LEAP can address the heart and the mind both. Okay. See, 2% kehne ko bada aasan hai. Sir, 2% de dijiye, 365 raaton ki chain ki neend soiye. But 2% koi kaatta nahi hai. Because 10 crore pe 2% 20 lakh hota hai. And you have to pray that this money never comes back. It's not very easy. Insurance cutting checks with a thought process of, because the mind says you have to do it, but the heart will not let you do it. So what we generally propose is, we generally propose, and this is deliverable to the extent of any amount of money, large. We have done trades for as little as 10 lakh, 25 lakhs, 10, 12 lakhs, whatever is the minimum amount. So not that it's only a big man's game. Even a 10 lakh portfolio can be hedged using a LEAP to as much as 2000 crore trade we have done on a single day. So it is not an academic thing, but what you do is, it is very emotionally easy to give away profits if you made. If I told somebody, you invest, if there is loss, the loss belongs to NSE. Profit, 80% belongs to you, 20% belongs to NSE. If let's assume I have reached a good level of 10 crore rupees, and I say, let me lock this in, and I outsource the risk to NSE, any fall from 10 crores equal to Nifty. So you can't hedge a mid-cap portfolio or a stock. This is only a large-cap portfolio which has a serious linkage to Nifty. Okay? I will protect myself if it goes down. If it goes up, I will give away 20% of the profits. So cost on day one is zero. Cost on day one is zero. Cost is only there when the market goes up and you make money. So we've productized it where it protects the first 20%. It protects the first 20%, not the full, because the markets don't fall more than 20% on a 3-year basis. And you give away only 15% of the profits.
Feroze, thank you so much. As always, it's been fun and it's been a good learning for me, and I'm sure for everybody here.